Okay, so we're at the front door. You walk in. It's an entryway. Closet. And then here is the formal living room. Go through here to the dining room. And then this is the kitchen.
Oh, yeah.
This is like a pantry area.
Yeah.
There's that. I'll go in there in a minute. From the kitchen, we go around the bend here. This is the laundry room. That's the sunroom. I'll go there in a minute. And then somewhere, the light. This is the mother-in-law suite. Okay, so goes like that. Comes out this way. Here's the bathroom. And in the bathroom, it's big. There's the shower. That doesn't meet code. Okay, two pedestal sinks. Can't miss that. Okay, so you walk in the door, and then there's this area here. It's not all that long. I picture it a little longer in my head, and it's not all that wide. This is the door that you could get to the inspector. I was not happy with the way that door locked. It goes out to the driveway. I'm not going to try to do it, but that's the driveway. And there's a bowl right there. I don't understand it. Okay, then in here is, whoops, a closet. And it's a fairly good size. So, I think a washer, dryer, and possibly a freezer and refrigerator could fit there. So that's good. But this is much shorter than I thought. I'll be interested to see how big it is. Okay, so from here. Oh, the kitchen is on dim. Oh, nice. Okay, then from here you go out to the sunroom. That's the door outside. Porch area there, the patio area there, and then here's the whole sunroom. And it has a kitchen window in it, and then another door, and then that's the chimney. Whoops, you can't see through this thing. It smells so bad in here. Chimney's right there, and then I guess that's the water heater. I don't know what that is. Okay, then through this door, we are in the family room, which connects to the kitchen. So from here is the family room. There's a fireplace. And then down here is the bedroom and bathrooms. This is the first bathroom. There's a little area out here that has storage all on this back wall that goes back, I don't know, maybe 12 inches, a little longer, maybe a little deeper. And then here's the tub angled that way with the toilet there. And then it's pretty small too, but there might be some, let's see, if we close this door. I guess that's how deep that shelving unit is, the storage area is. Okay, and then this way,
thank you,
across the hall. It's a bedroom, small.
They took it out and they put it in a beam. She said you go in the attic, look down the beam. I think it's 12 feet, it's 12 feet.
Okay.
So it took the place.
There's a utility closet.
So
all
that space up and down.
Linen closet.
So the beam was on the
floor. And then.
Well, no, it wasn't.
Oh,
it's out.
This
yeah.
way.
Yeah.
And there's another bedroom. And then. Oops. This way,
so yeah,
and then
this
is just the end of the hall there. And then here's the master. And behind here is a closet. It's very small. It works. And it just goes that far. Very small. Here is, let me show you this part, is the bathroom. And it goes as far as that closet. That's the shower. It's a little bigger than other showers, but kind of small. And then turn that off. there's the rest of that. Okay. And then the bath, or then the rest of the bedroom is actually pretty small. But I think it's doable. Okay. And then here's the closet. Okay. And then you just go back out this way. There's the feeling room. So if we try to remove that wall,
that's kind of how
and possibly
they
this wall.
Oops. Yes.
Between the living room
yeah.
and this family room, that wall, and then
yeah,
that wall over
there.
That's the question. The other option is to remove that wall and close this off to the kitchen. And extend the kitchen around the bed.
Yeah.